Welcome to Unite Coaching. Hello everyone. Welcome to Unite Coaching. This is the third video in Analysis and Design of a G+3 Building video series. In this video we are going to learn the process of assigning the loads over the structure. So let's start the process. For this, go to General, then Load and Definition. First of all, I will explain you which types of loads are likely to come over the structure. The first load is dead load. The self-weight of slab will be calculated by the formula shown. It is coming as 3.75 kN per meter square. The second load is self-weight of the structure. It will be directly applied in the Staad Pro itself. Next load is dead weight of walls. I have calculated three loads for three different walls, first for external walls, second for internal walls, and third for parapet wall. The formulas are shown here. The last loads to be applied are imposed loads. I have considered live load value as 3 kN per meter square for all the rooms. But, if you want to use standard values of live load, please refer Indian Standard Code 875. The floor finish load is taken as 1 kN per meter square. So, these are various loads, which are considered for design. I have not considered earthquake load and wind force in this video, as it will require more time. So, I will cover it in my other videos. So, let's assign these loads in Staad Pro. First, go to General, Load and Definition, click on Load Case Details, click Add. Select the load type as dead load for dead load. To assign this load, I will give load title as DL for dead load, LL for live load, and I will add them. For live load, the load type will be live load. Now click on DL, click on Add. First, I will add self-weight of structure. Keep factor as it is, and click Add. Now I will add self-weight of slab. For this, click on Floor Wall Load. The pressure intensity for slab load is 3.75 kN per meter square. And as it is acting in downward direction, we will add negative sign to it. Now come to the range. As the ground floor will not have any slab, the Y range will be 5 meter to 14 meter. Keep the X range and Z range as it is. And click Add. Next dead load is floor finish load. This will also be same as slab load, only the value will be different. So just put value as minus 1 kN per meter square. And click Add. Next dead load is weight of all the walls. It will be a member load. So, click on member load, select uniform force. The external wall load is 9 kN per meter. So the value of W1 will be minus 9. Keep D1, D2 and D3 value as it is. Click Add. Similarly, add dead load of internal wall which is 6.9 kN per meter. And parapet wall load is 3 kN per meter. Click Add. So this is it for dead load, click on close. Now we will add live load. For this, click on LL, click on add, click on floor load, put value of minus 3 kN per meter square. The range will be same as floor finish load, which was 5 meter and 14 meter. Click add, click close. In this way all loads are added. Now we will assign them one by one to the structure. For this, click on self-weight, click on assign to view, click assign, click yes. Slab load and floor finish loads will automatically be added. Now assign external wall load of 9 kN per meter. Now we will select the external walls of all the floors except parapet wall. For this, select front view, select the beams of all floors except top floor. Click on view selected objects only. Click on top view, select all the external walls. Check whether all the beams of all floors are selected or not. Now, click on assign to selected beams, click on assign, click yes. Now select top view and similarly assign internal wall load of -6.9 kN per meter. Click on top view, select all the internal walls. Check whether all the beams of all floors are selected or not. Now, click on assign to selected beams, click on assign, click yes. Now click on display whole structure. Select front view, select top floor only. Click on view selected objects only. Click on top view, select all the external walls for parapet. Now, click on assign to selected beams, click on assign, click yes. Now click on display whole structure. In this way, you can add different types of loads to the structure. Now, our model is ready to be analyzed. Click on Commands, click Analysis, click Perform Analysis, click OK. Click Analyze, Run Analysis. Click Save. In the next tutorial, we will design the same building using Indian Standard Code, IS 456-2000. Thanks for our videos. Please like, subscribe and share to Unite Coaching.